Did you see Clockwork's hero icon? It's totally themed.
Yeah, no, he has the Clockwork. It actually makes sense. Even though you won't see him on Torbjorn all that often for Clockwork, I mean, it fits. It fits just about as much as Melty repping all the D.Va icons.
Oh, that's right. I meant to bring that up. Cloud9 has only lost a couple maps recently. One of those is to Melty, which is kind of interesting. They're not a team that you'd expect to be able to beat Cloud9, but Melty is just... They remain to be a team that I just still have no idea. They can beat everyone. They can lose to anyone. They're just such a coin flip every time I see them play.
All right, so we're going. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, C9 Woo! Versus Splyce now underway here on Lijiang Tower. Thank you so much for waiting. We went on a weird and dark path there, X, for a while, but now we have Overwatch here, the centrist, yet again.
I had fun. I enjoy it. I enjoy interacting with chat and then, bringing up my lack of a childhood. So it's good. This is why I don't have to actually pay for therapy. This is why I have casting. It's wonderful. Do you think we're going to see this Bastion from Pure?
We very well could. Bastion that has been in play here on Lijiang from time to time, depends on what stage we're on. You don't usually see it too much here in the garden, but Pure wants to give it a shot. Why not? I'm down.
The only thing that makes me think we're not going to see it is that they're not really running like a Zarya and a Reinhardt with it. You would especially expect to run a Zarya, but maybe they're going to run it and Papa Smurf is going to just pop the bubble over him. So we'll see. Right now, the Splyce roster is Clockwork on Tracer, Kozen on Mercy, Pure on Bastion, Sickness on Soldier 76, Papa Smurf on Winston, and Flame on Reaper.
All right, we'll take a look here at the C9 squad. It's going to be Grego on the Lucio, Debit on Winston, Reaver on 76, Kaikai on Zarya, Sure4 on Pharah, and Adam on Mercy. So Pharah coming back into play here now that you don't have to worry about double 76s or anything crazy like that. And Debit right now leading the way, leaping right in to the Splyce side. Clockwork, though, punishing immediately, takes out Debit. First kill of the Splyce, and Splyce now counter leaping in turn. And this is not the worst look at Splyce as they pick up three quick kills, make it four. Flame just going off as Reaper in the middle.
Yeah, their hitscan dominating that early fight as Clockwork got in. Flame cleaned up as well, so DPS doing a ton of work right now, and this is a map that's so hard to take it back. They can really only aggress from two different angles. Cloud9, of course, is going to group up. They're going to try to come over the bridge.
C9 gonna be coming right back into it. Speed boost is out, but look at this. Splyce leaping right back into them. Papa Smurf leading the way, buying his team a bit of time, and they're pushing C9 back as the pulse bomb sticks. Down goes Grego, and Clockwork going off right now on Tracer, almost getting the triple kill. And I gotta say, I did not expect this to start at Lijiang. C9 actually getting it taken right to them right now, Hex.
Well, I think it's a really smart map pick because, you know, Cloud9's a team that's been together forever. They're gonna be a hard team to beat on Halo, things like that, but you can just out DM and out deathmatch them. Clockwork again gets another kill on Debbie.
And C9 again, this is not expected going in. They're having some issues. Sure4 though, getting over the top, will take out Kozen, but Clockwork the immediate punish. And Clockwork has just been the huge standout here. He's gotten kill after kill. Finally though, the raid boss is dead, and we'll see if C9 can do something off of this in the short time that Clockwork is down as they're moving in. Soundbearer on the way, Clockwork still running back to the fight. And C9 able to pick up the few extra kills they need. Flame is dead. And they should be able to retake this now, and take out Clockwork, a big reason for that.
Let me just tell you how good Debit is on Winston, and I know people may not agree that Winston takes less kill. He just one-on-one to Reaper. He dove a Reaper one-on-one to miss Winston. You shouldn't be able to do that. Debit did.
Oh no, by the way, even though C9s are getting the kills they need here, we still see a lot of stalling out coming out from this Splyce. They'll finally lose it, but they end up with 72% on the point. Now, retaking this point is pretty darn difficult. It's one of the harder points to retake in the entire game. C9 is going to have Graviton Surge at the ready and more. But we'll just have to see how this works out. It's not the worst look right now coming out of Splyce.
Yeah, we'll see what this pulse bomb does. That's kind of going to be, it's probably going to be the initiator of the fight. Clockwork's already looking, he tries to get in, tosses it, misses. Reaver does walk right over it, though.
Yeah, the pulse bomb didn't stick, but it doesn't matter. Reaver went into it. It's a double kill. Frank, so it doesn't quite work out as well for them as they might have liked. Still though, the aggression is real. Sure4 now moving in. Here comes a Death Blossom, setting them up. A triple kill for Sure4, knocking all of them right down. Well executed by C9, and C9 coming right back in.
Yeah, the good thing here for Splyce is that they're going to have their supports to initiate, and they have everything pretty much ready. I mean, Flame doesn't have Death Blossom yet. A couple shots get him there. Clockwork, we know how quickly that ult is going to charge. They have Soundbearer, they have Res, they have everything going.
Yeah, they're going right in. Here comes Attack Buzz though from Reaver. He's in the back line, not under pressure. Has a Soundbearer protecting him. Both Soundbearers, of course, around. And here comes Papa Smurf looking to knock people off the edge. Not going to do it. Two kills to C9. Res coming out, though, so both teams still into it. Papa Smurf still looking for the knockoffs, but everything is coming up C9 right now, X.
Yeah, I mean, being able to take down Cozen Claim and Clockwork there should pretty much end this fight. They flip it back over to their side, but it's been a pretty nice map so far for Splyce. Definitely not counting out of it just yet. This Death Blossom is going to be huge, and also Pulse Bomb is back up. Clockwork ate a huge bunch of spam on the way in, but he's healed up now.
I'll note, by the way, that Splyce was able to get a little bit of a cap there towards the end. They did add extra on. Both teams about to be tied 80%. If Splyce can win this next fight, they'll actually be in great position to win this game, so C9 cannot rest easy. A lot here might be dependent here on Kaikai. Is he going to land a big round time? Here comes Flame coming in the Death Blossom. Does not get the vibes looking for. Adam dies really early in this fight, but unfortunately, so did Cozen. There will be no res here for Splyce, and Clockwork, the last one to fall, 97%. That should be it. Round one, going to C9.
Tactical visor activated.
Yeah, they had a good look early, but then once Cloud9 regrouped, reformed, I think they just were a little bit stunned at how many people they lost early in those fights, and then they got a giant percentage at Splyce early on. But once Cloud9 got their feet under them, got warmed up a little bit, they were easily able to take that map. But I think still this is a game mode that Splyce has a better chance in than say, a typical payload or hybrid map. Mostly, again, because Clockwork just actually went nuts the first 3 minutes of that game.
Clockwork had himself a game and then some. It shows that if someone is having a good game, the variance that you can get in an FPS game like Overwatch, where, you know, Clockwork went off, was able to get the Baron C9, and Splyce came very close to winning that round. But you do have to win three rounds to win here on King of the Hill, and Clockwork will have to dig a little bit deeper here on Reaper, trying to make that happen as Splyce is out and running to the point.
So they're going to brawl on the point, not in the courtyard. Another quick pick takes out Debit.
Yeah, Clockwork, he took out Debit to start out the last game as well. Moves in, takes out Reaver. And Clockwork again opening the door here for Splyce. And Splyce going to take this first point off of the guns of Clockwork.
Can't ask more from one player. I mean, he got three kills there to open up the fight. Already almost has Death Blossom up.
Tickless has been doing pretty well here on the same six as well. Definitely did a lot of damage. Already has 50% ult charged up. Was a big part of supporting Clockwork in that last fight. But here comes C9. They're going to be on the way in. Reaver on the Tracer. A single Tracer, I might add. Sheriff, though, starting off the bang here. Able to take out Clockwork. The Beast is dead for Splyce. And now C9, they're in a good position here. They have a 6v5. They can wait a little bit. They make the res come out early. And Flame, though, able to counter Shuffle right away. Both teams using the res. And both 4v4 right now on the point. Cygnus, though, about to drop the tech visor. But no, Shuffle getting directly in on him. Getting the double kill. Has Death Blossom at the ready, but might not even need it here, as he's just cleaning people up with left clicks. So Shuffle saying one good Reaper play deserves another. Bring it right back to Clockwork.
Yeah, actually some pretty good play there from both Pure and Sickness towards the end. They both had ultimates up. Sometimes you'll see teams bust those out and just try to get anything back in the fight, but they knew they already lost two. They lost one of their most important players, most importantly, so now they're going to save up for this next fight.
Sheriff going in. Death Blossom is immediately taken out. The Soundbearer just ruining his day. Soundbearer came out here from the defense of C9, but here comes Attack Visor, Tracer in all sorts of trouble, having to just run right away. Meanwhile, though, on the point, both teams getting into it. Clockwork dropping the Death Blossom, only getting one kill as both teams incredibly depleted, but C9 definitely with a bit more advantage here, Hex.
Yeah, they just got the better end of that fight. As you mentioned, the Death Blossom didn't really get everything they wanted off of it. Pure's gonna go down late, followed by Sickness. There was a moment where Clockwork had the shield, he had Death Blossom up, chose to find a different timing there, wraithed out of it, and I think maybe his first timing, his first instinct would have been better there to get the Death Blossom up early in that fight rather than later.
So, defense of C9 hanging in here again. Very reminiscent of the first round, where again, Splyce was able to take the very first fight, and now they're just sort of stuck trying to fight it back. Ult-wise, they're not in the war situation. Of course, they do have Graviton Surge, and we'll see if Flame can make the most of it here. Splyce now on the attack, looking for an opportunity. I think Flame will just drop this early. I don't think he's going to be too picky here. Sheriff, though, takes out Clockwork very early in the fight, and this is already kind of problematic here for Splyce. I think they lost their opportunity.
Yeah, they also lost some Mercy somewhere in that fight as well, and the Primal Rage is going off here. The Graviton comes in late.
Attack Visor comes in late as well. Felt like a little bit of panic Attack Visor coming up from Sickness, but he's able to stay alive. Somehow gets the double kill. It was down to 40 HP at the Winston on him. Somehow came right back alive, and despite the early picks, we see that Splyce is able to turn it back in their favor, and I'm just amazed Sickness stayed alive. You should have just died to the Winston there, but somehow Attack Visor call really working out for him.
Yeah, the Graviton only grabbed two. They did have some follow-up, though, for it, as Clockwork was back alive. He almost has Death Blossom. Right now, though, Cloud9 is pretty much loaded as far as their ults go. I think we're going to see a big combination coming up.
Oh, Graviton coming in here from Kai Kai. Only gets one. It got stuck on Papa Smurf's body. That was just weird. Here comes Death Blossom on the Kai from Clockwork. Takes out two. Clockwork down deep. Takes out Adam, but not before the res. Heroes never die. C9 right back in the fight as Sure4. Bringing it right back to Clockwork. Able to take him out. C9 now on five kills. Turning it around, and oh my goodness, what if Clockwork could have killed Adam just half a second earlier, Hex?
That's the most, yeah, it's definitely a what if. A split seconds is why they lost that fight, because he was so close, he knew it was coming up, he tried to get in there, got his shots off, and it was just bang bang, the res came off, unable to kill him before it comes off. If he does, they definitely hold that point and probably take that stage.
Alrighty, well, Splyce now on the verge of losing this map. It is a best out of five, so there's still plenty of maps left here to go. But I gotta say, this is not the tale that the scores show. Splyce has been playing this very, very close thus far.
Yeah, it's a lot closer than I expected, to be honest. Maybe that's King of the Hill coming into it. Maybe it's Clockwork just playing out of his mind right now. I think that's kind of the standard of Clockwork, though. He's just that good of a player. He needs a little more help from his team around him. It seems a little more cohesion from Cloud9, but Splyce has really given them a fight to see what they can bring on the stage of Control Center? Control Center.
Yep, this is the control center here on Legion. Both teams getting into him. We'll see again. Will Splyce have the better opening? They've done it twice in a row.
As
Flame and Sickness able to get to the back. Adam is down. There will be no res. And just like this again, Splyce in a great opportunity now to actually take first control of this control center.
You can't ask for a better opening than that. You take down both supports as your first two kills. Clockwork's going to chase it down, takes down Deb. But they'd be smart to get out now because there's no reason to be pushing that far forward. They're good. They don't bleed any players up there.
Everything is going well for Splyce in the very beginning of the game, and then C9 just finds a way of taking it back. As look at Reaver right now, he's going around the flank, taking the middle ground here. Here comes Attack Visor, moving right in, almost gets Kozen, does get Kozen. The Mercy, already dead from that long away, is under a little bit of assault here, but now there's no res up for the side of Splyce, and healing-wise, they're just getting picked apart right now, Hex.
Yeah, Clockwork goes down to Reaver. They definitely have the advantage and they know it. They're going to press it because even if they lose everyone, they're going to have the res up, whereas Splyce will not. So now they get a more advantageous position. Sure4 is going to be on this fair, and now we're going to see what Cloud9 can do, because when you have control at this point and you have a Pharah combo, you become very hard to dislodge. They actually know this. They're going to take a different angle of attack as Splyce.
Well, here they come. Soundbearer on the way. Splyce moving right back in. Clockwork setting the pace. Able to take out two. And here comes the Death Blossom right into the Soundbearer team. Takes out Grego. Makes it a double kill. And Splyce bringing it right back. Really close match so far.
Yeah, I'm super impressed with Splyce playing on King of the Hill right now. So much so that Sure4 has to get off of that Pharah. He comes up on McCree instead, just not getting what he wants out of that. It's just really smart knowing that they weren't going to come into the side. Because when a team's established with their combo up top, you have to come in from a different place. They knew that. They did. They took that.
Sure4 right now laying the damage on McCree. Is switching the McCree. Used to be on the Pharah. And I like this. Sure4 definitely is one of the better McCrees in the game. Definitely can make it work out. And Deadeye is incredibly effective here in the control center, too, if you get the right opportunity. But for now, look at how Splyce is playing. They're playing really far back. They're healing up the poke, and they're not giving C9 what they want. But here comes C9. They're on the way. Here comes the Graviton Surge. The Attack Visor is out. Kai Kai got into the middle of it with Death Blossom. Took out Mercy immediately. Three quick kills here for the side of C9. And with the Mercy being down, this should be C9's capture.
Yeah, that's going to be it. I mean, Papa Smurf is going to delay a little bit to make sure they get a little bit more percentage on that point. He eventually goes down, but you mentioned it. Once you lose the Mercy in that fight, it's pretty much over. You can maybe stall out, but they're not necessarily going to be able to sustain. It's a pretty long walk. It's a pretty big King of the Hill map to get back to the point, so that was definitely that fight. But they do have some stuff to work with here. Attack Visor is going to be up. They do have that Resurrection.
Look at Cherfar, though. He's sitting here on the top, and as the offense rolls in, do they realize it's high noon in the purest of ways? Because you can't get more high than Cherfar right now. Comes in, not able to get too much from that. Both teams trying out one for one at the moment. Clockwork in the back line. C9, though, still appears to be in firm control. Kai Kai taking out Papa Smurf. And Clockwork, even though he got into the back line, did not have an opportunity to use Death Blossom. Just going to get taken out.
Way too deep. I think they actually wanted him to die earlier, which is why he was in the middle of those four people, because the Rez was coming. Rez came off as he was dying, so he gets he misses the boat, as it were, and is going to be out of that fight, unable to bring him back up for that Death Blossom. But like you said, he does have Death Blossom up here. They're at 80%. It's going to be about 80 to 80 the next time the fight happens.
Oh no, Clockwork almost going down. Able to Wraith Form just in time. Very lucky he didn't just get comboed out of that. And a lot's going to depend on Clockwork here. Can he get a Valley Death Blossom? He's moving in, going to get hooked once again. Gets one kill before going down. Both teams 5v5 here on the point, but no Sheriff or no Clockwork. It's going to be rough. Wad is on Flame Shoulders here, 2v2 here on the point. Adam did go down.
Yep. Got Adam. Cozen has his res as well. They just need to clean out the rest of this. Clockwork is going to come in. He Death Blossoms.
He Death Blossoms, takes out two. He's going to get rezzed up immediately, and this is not the worst. Adam's going to be back in the fight in a moment, though. He'll have a rez of his own. But now for Splyce, all hands are on deck. They must stay here on the point if they want any chance of turning this map around. But after that rez, they are able to do that. Adam was not able to get back in time. And 85% to 99%. So now it's C9 on the hot seat here, Hex. They have to win this next fight, or they are going to lose this game.
Right now, they should not be this clumped up because Graviton is coming in.
Graviton Surge comes out. Four people of Splyce hooked right in. The fault, though, isn't quite there as Papa Smurf, the lowest, ends up popping Primal Rage. Adam is already down. Two kills here for Splyce. And Hex, are they going to do it? They are. They take this round right away from C9. I'm actually surprised C9 wasn't able to keep it in overtime. That was weird.
Well, they got Primal Rage and punched off, so that was part of it. But yeah, that Graviton came and grabbed three. Clockwork just wraithed out of it. Tracer blinked out of it, and then Primal Rage. So it got absolutely nothing done.
All right, so Splyce is fighting here. They have bloodied C9 just a little bit, and keeping open the option of a reverse sweep here on Lijiang. Good stuff coming up from Splyce. And now here's the question, will C9 actually win the opening fight? Because every opening fight right now, on all three rounds, has gone to Splyce. I'm not sure if Splyce is doing better, but they are doing better, Hex.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of the point where it's not necessarily positioning. It's really just comes down to pure aim at those first fights. The Braveheart run straight at each other and shoot each other, and it's really just been Clockwork getting the better of it.
Clockwork right now moving in, looking for his opportunity. Not going quite as in, but here comes Papa Smurf leading the way. They're going right in. The coordination between Clockwork and Papa Smurf has been pretty good. They don't get the pickoff they're looking for, and Papa Smurf ends up paying the price. Two kills here for C9, and C9 might be winning this first fight, but Pure and Clockwork coming right back, so let's see how it goes. I do think Sherfor is going to be able to clean this up, though.
They didn't hold on commit to that. I mean, they jumped in, they speed boosted in everything. Clockwork got like a shot off. I think he ate a ton of damage early, wraithed out of it. So then they had to back up off the bridge. I think like maybe just go full bore on that. So they did initiate and then decided to back out almost immediately and lost in that fight.
Flame tried to go in there for the pickoff, but just ran right in the sheer forward. Got effectively one shot. And C9 in a much stronger position here, 20%, and we'll see if Splyce can actually turn this back in their favor, but they're not going to have that opening win to their credit, which they had all three rounds before. So they're moving in, and Papa Smurf just getting torn apart right now from Sherfor. He goes down super early in the fight. Two kills here for C9, and they are holding it in right now, Hex. And Splyce, they just need to back up and regroup.
Yeah, I mean, again, it was kind of initiation where they didn't really all commit to it. Flame tried to go in and get to the back lines. He got taken out, so I think that might have stalled out the fight. Then, of course, Papa Smurf jumped in. No one followed him in, so he got picked off pretty early. They do have some ults to work with here. This is one of their better chances to win a fight. Pulse Bomb hits nothing.
Pulse Bomb hit nothing. Sherfor's still hanging on the Death Blossom, and here he goes, right onto the bridge, taking out three, setting up C9, and the two people that are coming in the flank here, Pure And Flame, not quite what they want. They just need the back out, tails between their legs. C9 now at 65% and a mere 35% away from winning this map.
They need to get this big death blossom off, and it's going to be a sound barrier and a death blossom if they can find which angle to take. They're going to go right over the bridge.
Proton comes out. Everyone from Splyce is grouped in there, and even with the sound barrier, I'm not sure they're going to survive. First kill goes to C9 here. They're looking for more. They're pushing the bridge. Reaver with the attack visor in the back. Able to take out Sickness. This is three kills for C9, and I'm not sure if Splyce is even going to be able to get back here in time for one last push hex.
This is one of the big problems of coming over the bridge, is you're so grouped up, and when the other team is running Azaria and you haven't seen Graviton in a while, that's gonna happen. I mean, honestly, there's no good way to come in, because they come in the other side, they get Graviton and Death Blossomed anyway. Just how the map is.
Surefour going in, able to get shot over shot. Here comes a Death Blossom, makes it a 3K, and that is going to be it. Well fought by Splyce, but just not enough. C9 going to take map one right away from them, but Hex, that was way closer than I expected going in.
Yeah, I agree. It's kind of what we thought about Splyce, though, right? They're mechanically all gifted people. They're all very good players. It always just comes down to the coordination in the fights and trying to get the transitions and things going. So they're all very good at video games and at FPSs in general. It's just, are they good as a team in Overwatch yet? We'll see. The next map is probably going to be a payload. So that might be a better barometer of where they're actually at as far as Overwatch goes in general, because they have the talent on this squad to be able to win fights 1v1, and mechanically they're sound. It has always just been, can they win team fights, can they coordinate, can they transition, can they